I'm Stressa James, and you're watching Disney Channel. Bum, bum, ba-dum.
Hi, Kelsey. I've been asked to tell you one last thing I'd like to say to you, and I'm choosing not to say a last thing, but I will say things to you. I'm going to miss you very much. You've been a wonderful next-door neighbor. I don't really believe in goodbyes. I don't believe this is the last time we're going to see you, even though you're going to be pretty far away. I've loved working with you. You have brought so many good ideas, and you've taught the students who you feed to me so very well that I am going to miss you, but I am confident we will be hearing great things about you and your future, and I really hope that you have a wonderful time being closer to home. I know family means so much to you, as it does to all of us. It'll be good to be home for you, and we'll be thinking about you and keeping in touch with you. Good luck.
Hi, Mrs. Howald. One of the things I'm going to miss most about you is you asking me how I feel every day and asking me if I'm on Team Tressa. And even when I'm not, you're always there for me. And I really appreciate it because I always know I have someone in my corner. And I know you said you're going to email Mr. McEwen every day and ask him how I am and if I'm on Team Tressa, but it won't be the same because you're not there and you're not going to tell me every time I say no to be on Team Tressa because no one else will be except for you. So thank you for everything that you've done, and I'll miss you a lot.
My favorite memory of Mrs. Howald would probably have to be the day that she was like pretending to be angry at us. We were all just like, we just didn't know what to do. It was kind of scary, but like after she had like, it was a joke, it wasn't like serious. After she was done with her acting or whatever, she told us that she was joking, like she wasn't actually angry at us. And we all thought it was like hilarious because her acting was like really good and we were all like terrified. And it was, yeah, I don't know. It was a good memory. Even though I was terrified at the time, it's nice to look back on.
Mrs. Howald, my favorite thing about you is that you are just such a caring individual. You care so much, not just about your job, but also about the students. And that is felt by all of us. You will go out of your way just to make sure that students feel all right and that they know that they are loved and accepted, and that is so important. Thank you for everything you do. You will be so missed.
So my first impression of Mrs. Howald was that she was super sweet and really energetic and super encouraging, which in the classroom, especially on the first few days of school, made me feel like I could like pretty much do anything.
Yeah. My first great memory of you was when I heard you playing the ukulele in the hallways. I thought that was really cool, and it just made the environment so much fun. I can't even begin to tell you all the things I'm grateful for you giving me rides, for so many different things, especially your wonderful upbeat way and your smiley face. Good luck with everything. We'll miss you.
Go ahead.
Hi, Kelsey. Just wanted to say thanks for the past couple years that we've had. We're gonna miss you around here. The thing that I am gonna most miss and love about you is your patience with the students, and you are always positive, and you always have an encouraging word and a helping hand for others. So wish you the best of luck to you and Nick, and
go ahead.
Oh, we're going? Okay. Thank you for being such a positive role model this year for me, as well as a really good friend. I'm sad to see you go, but it was great to get to know you over the year. Looking forward to a lot of your successes in the next coming years. Definitely feel free to reach back out to me, and that's pretty awesome to get to know you. See ya.
So I was asked the question, what's my favorite memory of Mrs. Howell? I have a lot, but one of my favorites is when we were in class and you were teaching something, I don't remember what it was, and you were giving examples, but I didn't understand them. So you gave another example, and it was you hitting me with your car, and it was so funny, and everybody laughed. And I know you said you didn't remember, but it was so funny. And then another one of my favorite memories is when you were in Mr. McEwen's class, and I was wearing an off-the-shoulder top, and you and Mr. McEwen were snickering about my shoulder showing, about how it disobeyed the dress code and stuff. And Mr. McEwen looked at me and he said,
oh, Mrs. Howald, like, do you have anything that you need to say to Kaylee? And then you said that my shoulders were showing or something. And then I was like, shut up, Ms. Becker. And it was so funny, and I got a Starburst for it. And then there's a lot more. And another one is how I wrote my free verse poem about Nick and Schmorgy. But a long story short, like, this entire year has been filled with so many memories, and all of my favorite ones were with you.
Hey, Mrs. Howald. I just wanted to say one last thing to you before you leave for Virginia. I just wanted to thank you so much for how much you helped me my sophomore year. It was a tough year, and you were definitely there for me, both inside and outside of school. You also continued to help me so much this year, even though I wasn't technically your student, and I appreciate it so much. So just keep being you, please, because every student needs someone like you.
I will miss having an intellectually stimulating conversation with a fellow introvert over lunch hour.
My question was, what is your favorite thing to tease Mrs. Howald about? And my favorite thing to tease Mrs. Howald about was Chris Pratt and syrupy biscuits, along with teaming up with Mr. McEwen and going on about how movies are way better than books, always. So yeah, I'm really gonna miss you, Mrs. Howell.
I have been asked, what is my favorite thing to tease Miss Howell about? And I would have to say it's her home state of West Virginia. And the reason I like this one the most is because I've stayed with it for so long that people are really starting to question if she is actually from West Virginia. So I would say that's probably my favorite one, but there are so many to pick from. Gonna miss you, Miss Howell.
Yeah. Hi, Miss Howell. I'm just so thankful for, like, your presence in Bullingdon High School, because you're just such a positive energy. Like, walking down the hallway, just seeing you walk around playing your ukulele, saying hi to all your students, you bring such a positive light to everyone's world and everyone's day. Like, every single time I just walk past you in the hallway and you say hi to me, I smile because I just love you that much. And you've been such a great teacher, and you've inspired me, like, when I become a teacher, to realize that there's not always a certain game plan you have to have, and that sometimes you have to go with it. And the way you went with it during your class when I had you was absolutely stunning and amazing, and I wish to have that reach of an adaptability when I become a teacher. Thank you for being here.
Go ahead.
Mrs. Howell, you're just such a caring and kind person that has really, like, made an impact on everyone that you've interacted with and just everyone that you ever meet. And I know personally you made sophomore year very special with all the pranks and enjoyment that I got out of that class, and really changed my understanding of, like, English and that sort of thing. And I do not know what we will do here without you, but I wish the best for you in whatever you're doing.
Go ahead.
Hi, Kelsey. I'm going to miss you so much. You've made me a better teacher. You've made me a better person. And so I'm holding what you made me, so we know what we are, but know not what we may be. And I know what you're going to be. You're going to be fabulous in your next school, and your students are going to be totally benefit from you. Best of luck. Go Virginia. And you got this.
What was Mrs. Howald's greatest impact on you? She has impacted me in many ways, but what sticks out to me the most is her sense of humor. Whenever I had a rough day, I could just go to her and I knew that we would have a good laugh and everything would be okay.
Some things that I think of when I think of Kelsey and that I'm gonna miss the ukulele, because she's always outside my door playing the ukulele on Fridays. I'm gonna miss that. I'm gonna miss her positive attitude, the way she works with people, the way she looks at the world. I'm gonna miss her coming over to talk out loud and talk through her problems. Not really ask questions, but kind of talk out loud and think things through and bounce ideas. Because not only did that help her, but it really helped me. It helped me to look at things in a different way. I'm gonna really miss her because I wanted my son to have her. My son's gonna be a freshman next year at the high school, and I wanted him to have her as a teacher. And unfortunately, he isn't gonna get that opportunity, because I try to put really good role models around my my own children, and she is certainly a great role model for our kids.
Mom's always shown me like how to look at the bright side of the day, and I'm really appreciative of that. And she also just makes me happier just being in her room and giving a positive energy.
Go ahead. Okay. Miss Howell, you are an awesome teacher, and you have been an awesome mentor to me this year. You always have a great spirit every day, which intimidated me, honestly, at the beginning of the year. I'm like, this girl is like Superwoman. So I was like, how am I going to add up to how awesome she is? And I hope I did you proud. So I every day looked forward to taking your advice, talking to you, and reflecting on my own career, starting out. As you have 3 years in, you're already a seasoned professional, and each and every day I was impressed, and you're gonna do amazing things, and I'm so happy I got to know you.
Hey, Mrs. Howald.
Hi, we just wanted to say thank you for everything that you've done for us.
And well, we're gonna miss you so much.
Yeah, don't be stressa, don't be a messa, be aggressa, and don't get depressa.
Don't be a stranger, and we love you a ton.
We'll miss you a lot.
Also, this is Cuddles, Tressa's dog. I'm obsessed with her.
Bye.